Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Grade 4s and grade 5s. Today our fiqh lesson is a continuation from last week on the lesson of tayammum. Last week we discussed the fara'id acts of tayammum, things that break tayammum, the method of tayammum, and today we will continue on the items on which tayammum can be made. So tayammum can be made on tahir, which means clean, soil, or sand. Place your hand, dust it, and you can make tayammum. You can dust your hands on stones, no matter what kind of stones they are. You can use limestones. Limestones are those whitish kind of stones, and the lime sand. Unbaked clay pots. So you can dust your hand, tap your hand onto an unbaked clay pot and use it to make tayammum. Mud walls, dust your hands onto mud walls and tayammum can be made. Unbaked bricks. Different kind of soil. There's different kinds of soils from the sand. You will see how they all look. So all kinds of soil. You get a thick clayish soil, the silt, the flowing sand. So all this running, the sand, it's so like running and flowing. So all kinds of sand, no matter how it looks, you can make tayammum using those sand. Now, tayammum cannot be made on metal and glass. So you'll see here in this picture, I have a picture of a car. Car is made out of metal, and obviously its windows are made out of glass. But if the metal and glass has dust, as you can see, then you can use the dust on the metal and glass. But if there's no dust, you cannot touch the metal and glass for the use of tayammum. Now, tayammum cannot be made on wood. But if there is thick dust on the wood, then you may touch that dust to make tayammum. Tayammum cannot be made on things that melt like plastic, and it cannot be made on things that rot, and that is food items. And tayammum cannot be made on things that burn to ashes, and that is paper. So these are the items on which tayammum can be made and cannot be made. This is our lesson for today. Alhamdulillah, we have concluded our lesson on tayammum, and we have also concluded our lessons of fiqh for this term. Inshallah, we will continue with the following lessons next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.